There's a shutter missing on that top window. Here's a view of the street. It's near the intersection of this other street. There's some mildew or moss growing on the outside of the side of the house. Here are the two air conditioning units. That's just a warning label. The other one is exactly the same. Tempstar Heating and Cooling. The backyard is shallow and it looks like there's a wet spot. We had a lot of rain yesterday. There's the slide, kids slide. Here's the patio. I'm gonna try to get as much of the slab as I can. There's a pressure gauge attached to this, maybe where a propane tank or something is connected for gas to the fireplace. There's a little mildew along the back of the sliding door. Nothing remarkable about the slab that I can tell. You're going to want a downspout here to redirect water away from the house. Here are the two front windows. They're wrapped in vinyl and surrounded by stone. There is no exterior chimney or bricks to be photographed. Here's the front door. There is wood trim around the front door, but I don't see any peeling paint or any water penetration be concerned about. Let's go inside. There's no power on. This is the entryway. That's the back sliding door. Here are the stairs. Fingerprints all over the wall. That's why we think it should be painted, but it's all very neutral, very white. Here's the dining room. Not seeing any water stains. This is the breakfast area floor, and I'm finding a bunch of dead ants in here. So perhaps they have been treated and the ants are dead. They just haven't been swept up. But I would highly recommend, and your bank will probably require a full pest inspection, which would include inspecting for termites and other wood destroying insects. Okay, these walls don't make any sense to you until you see the kitchen, which is here. Kitchen has some recessed lighting. It's nice. But this is the breakfast corner I was telling you about. There is a fireplace, but it does not have any external chimney because there's gas logs in it. The master bedroom is on the main floor, and it's all very neutral. Two windows, they did leave the blinds. There's kind of some heavy traffic pattern here, but this carpeting might clean up with a professional carpet cleaner. And here's the master bathroom. Nothing remarkable that I can tell to share with you. Just painting the walk-in closet. Here is the water heater. And the garage looks fairly new. I see a serial number. I don't see a date on it. It is electric. No, I don't see a date, but it was probably brand new when the house was built just a few years ago. Couple holes in the wall in the garage here, no big deal. Probably don't even need to repair those to rent it. There's the electrical box. Now let's go upstairs. Okay, we're upstairs. This is one of the bedrooms on the back side of the house. What we're looking for is any ceiling stains that might indicate either a roof trouble or a trouble with a condensing unit, which should be in the attic. Sometimes they're in a pan, and if the pan system gets clogged, then that could overflow in the attic and make a water stain. This is the bonus room with a closet, so it's really can be called a fourth bedroom. Painting needed. Nothing really remarkable here. This is the hall bath. There's no power on, so I can't turn on any lights on for you. So those two bedrooms, and here is the last bedroom. I'm not seeing anything I would call a stain on the ceiling. Very boring being all white for this movie, but that's what it is. This is a closet in one of the upstairs bedroom. It has a light switch, but the light fixture has been removed, so that would need to be replaced. Shouldn't be too difficult for a handyman. Here's a view of the cold air return vent. It's in the ceiling of the second floor. Don't know if you can see it, but it is very dirty and dusty. That tells me the filters have not been changed on it. That may be the reason why the upstairs unit is not functioning according to the listing agent. And that's about all I can point out regarding the ceiling in the second story.